Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. This is Alessandra from Color Analysis Studio and we are here today with Lucio.
Hi.
Okay guys, so before we start with this analysis, please consider to subscribe to this channel and follow us on Instagram. And if you are interested in a color analysis session here in Melbourne, Australia or online, feel free to visit our website coloranalysis.au. And now we're ready to start. Guys, I'm very excited today to finally analyze Lucio's colors. Lucio is my partner, so finally I'm gonna see which season he is, right?
Yeah, I'm very excited as well to know which is my palette.
To be completely honest, I already analyzed Lucio during my training, but my school was using a different method, so I never analyzed Lucio with this method, with our method, so I will be very, very happy to finally discover his season. Okay, so Lucio, the first phase of an analysis is the undertone phase. So during this phase, we need to cover your clothes and also your hair. Finally, I see you with this game. In the first part of the analysis, we are not choosing your best colors, but we just need to see how your skin reacts to different colors temperature. Okay. So we need to compare two colors, okay, that have a different undertone. So this one is a tomato red, yellow based, and we're comparing with the raspberry red that is blue based. Can you tell the difference here?
Yeah, I can see the difference, yeah.
This one is more fuchsia, this one is more orange.
Okay.
So warm and cool. Don't look at the color because we don't care about the color right now, but we just need to look at your face and how it changed when we move from here, so warm, to cool. What do you notice?
Well, I think that with the cool color, I look a little bit more pale.
So what happens is totally normal, because imagine that this one is a yellow-based color, so it's gonna reflect on your skin a yellow light, so it's normal to gain more color with the warm red. Now, the point is that we need to understand if this color that we are gaining is something natural or is something artificial. What I'm noticing is that probably your complex in general have some warmth, so this yellow that you are gaining is probably quite harmonic. However, you don't change dramatically when we move on to the cool one. You lose a touch of color, you're right, you look a little bit paler, but the difference is not huge. I prefer you in this one because you look more colorful and healthy. But not terrible with this one. I see a change in your lip colors, okay, quite a lot. In this case, they look dry and they lose color. While in this case, they gain a little bit of color. So this time we will compare a salmon pink, yellow based, warm, versus a cool pink. Definitely in this case, you look very in harmony with this color because it's matching your undertone better, okay? You gain this beautiful cinnamon color that you have, that is very, very beautiful with this color, really emphasized by the salmon pink, while in this case this pale pink, it seems that this cool pink is stealing colors from your face, so in this case you look very, very pale. I can notice it better than with the reds. So warm, cool. Yeah, because I think that in this case is more visible because the colors are also lighter, okay? So probably we see it better. Usually pinks are a very good indicator to understand the undertone of someone. And now we will compare two darker colors. And in this case we will compare a blue navy, cool, versus a brown that is warm. In here, the difference is not huge, if I have to be honest. Probably it's not 50-50, I still prefer the effect of brown on his skin, but the difference is definitely, you know, not as evident as with the previous colors, okay? So in this case, blue navy is working. Brown is a touch better, but it's not very, very visible in this case, is undertone. We are gonna compare now two whites. This one is a creamy white with a touch of yellow in it, compared to a vivid white. Even in this case, I think that the difference is huge. What do you think? You prefer yourself with the creamy white or with the vivid white?
I would prefer the creamy white.
It's more delicate on your skin, right? Definitely better. It's more gentle and delicate. While in this case, I think that the vivid white, it's a little bit harsh on you. It seems like very separated from your feature. I don't see this flow in your colors with the vivid white. While with the creamy white, you are very harmonious. So his undertone, guys, is not very warm. We can say that he's slightly warm. We prefer warm colors on him, but we need to confirm his warmth with the metals. So we're gonna compare a gold with silver. What do you prefer, Lucio, silver or gold?
Let me see the gold. I think the gold looks better.
The gold look better. Yeah. Looks better, yeah. I think that the gold in this case will be more in harmony with your feature. Silver will be very visible on your skin, while gold is more, it blends better into your feature because it's matching your undertone. So gold better than silver. And when we compare blue with rust, I think that rust in this case is more gentle. I don't mind the blue, not really for the undertone, but for its intensity. So I think this is already a good start to, you know, train our eyes for the next phase, that is gonna be the intensity. I don't really mind this blue in terms of intensity. Give you a good light. If I consider the undertone, totally wrong, it's too harsh on you. While this one is more gentle and sophisticated. Silver and blue are a little bit harsh and separated from your feature, while gold and rust are more harmonious with your skin colors in general. Have a look, guys, at his face now. Is divided in half. Very, lifted on this side, and here very gray and pale, that is, you know, going down a little bit. So that's something very, very interesting. Can you notice that you have an asymmetric face right now?
Yeah, I can see.
This is higher.
Different, yeah.
And this one is look smaller and going down.
Okay.
So blue and silver, or gold and rust.
Yeah, it looks better, this combination.
So guys, cool colors on him. Warm colors, definitely much better, right?
See
the colors. The light that you are gaining with this warm colors, much better than this one. So Lucio, we discovered that your undertone is warm, and we can definitely exclude the two cool seasons, winter and summer. So now it's gonna be a matter of intensity. We will see how bright your colors are, or if they are more muted and you have more gray in your complex. So let's have a look at two greens, a bright green from the spring palette and an olive green, soft, from the autumn palette. So where do you think your level of intensity is fitting? Are you similar to this one, or are you more similar to the olive green?
I think in this one.
This one is not bad. It's not bad because the undertone is definitely correct. The intensity probably is a little bit too high here. I don't know if you can realize that when you look at yourself in the mirror, you are very attracted to see the color.
Yeah, because they are very bright, no?
It's very bright, right? Yeah. So you immediately stare at the color and lose the focus from your face. As soon as I remove that and I place the correct one, you become the focus because you don't look the color too much, but you really have in first spot your face. Probably this one is a touch too soft though. Your level of intensity is probably closer to the olive green, but not as soft as the olive green. I think it's more clear when you compare a collection of colors together. And in this case, they are all warm, okay? So they are all gonna look very, very good on you. But in this case, they have a high level of intensity, medium level of intensity, much better, low level of intensity. You are very in the middle, okay? So if I have to choose the best one between those three, I think that this one is more harmonious with your color, and this one probably is a little bit too high. Especially some. So if you compare, for example, this scale of orange, this one are much better, right? Even the green. So definitely not high. This one are a little bit too soft, okay? Especially probably this range here of yellow and orange. You can definitely go a little bit high in intensity, but have a look at the blue and the purple. I think that in this range here, they look better than this one. I think you are somewhere in between those two. So your level of intensity is definitely medium low. Warm undertone and medium low level of intensity means autumn. So welcome to the autumn palette, because I'm autumn too. We are both autumn, yeah. And now we're gonna discover your subgroup, okay? Because autumn is divided in three main subgroups, which represent the main characteristic of the autumn palette. Autumn is warm, deep, and soft, and we need to compare different colors from different subgroups to understand which is the predominant characteristic of Lucio. It's gonna be the warmth, the depth, or the softness. Now we are gonna go inside your season, and every single colors will look good on you. So let's start with the first subgroup, that is the autumn soft palette, and let's start with this olive green that we already saw in the intensity phase. Remember, yeah. Olive green is gonna be one neutral that definitely you can introduce in your wardrobe. Maybe you can go a little bit higher in intensity. So since I'm very picky in choosing your subgroup, I can start to see that probably this olive green directly close to your face is a little bit too soft. You can go a little bit higher in intensity here.
So that means that I can use this color or not?
Yeah, so when we analyze the subgroups in general, we are being very picky. The main part is that you are in autumn, so you can definitely use all the colors that I'm gonna show you from the autumn palette. This is one of your colors. I can start to see how more intense colors probably will look even better. This means that you can use this, but we will find better greens probably for you. Mustard yellow, beautiful. You work very, very well with yellow, I think. Probably is one of your best colors in general, very warm.
I'm wearing yellow today.
Yes, you're wearing even a better yellow, okay? Because it's a little bit brighter than this one. So in this case, since we're inside the soft subgroup, all the colors are very soft because the softness is their main characteristic. Definitely, yellow is a very good color. The one that you're wearing is even better than this one because it's slightly more intense. Oh, stunning, this one. Beautiful, beautiful red. Soft, but in this case, I think that is working better than the mustard because since it's darker, appears more, as more intense. And camel, soft camel. It can be one of your neutrals, but I really think that maybe close to your face, you need a little bit intensity, more intensity. You're not as soft as this one. Maybe you can wear a pair of pants. I made you buy the pair of pants in this color, right? Well, the olive and the soft camel. So in terms of pants, perfect, because on top of it, you can maybe put close to your face brighter red like this one. From the autumn soft palette, we're gonna move to the autumn deep palette. In this case, we're going up in intensity. The main characteristic of the colors in this case is the depth, and the colors are a little bit more intense than the the one that we saw before, because we're going higher in intensity. Let's start with this beautiful brown, dark brown. That's an excellent neutral for you, and it's working much better than the soft one that we saw before. Do you remember when we saw this soft camel? We didn't like it so much as your best color, okay? The thing is that when we compare colors and we are starting, you know, to get in detail about your specific subgroup, we can realize that in this case, a high intensity brown and a deeper brown in general is working better than a soft one.
Yeah, it's very obvious, yeah. You can see the difference.
You can see. Eggplant, another beautiful color. You don't have anything in this color, right? I think we should start to...
It would be interesting to introduce it on my wardrobe. Let's see.
Imagine a jacket on top of your yellow shirt that you're wearing today. Oh, wow. That's your favorite
this
color.
I love this color.
You love this color. Yeah. And it's working very well because it's the perfect blue for an autumn, because it's not a cool blue. Blue is a very difficult color for an autumn. In this case, teal is working because it has a lot of yellow in it. So, autumn people, go for your teal. Wow, that's stunning. I can see you now shining, yeah. Right? And it's working better than the soft one that we saw previously. This one was working very well on you. But again, when we compare colors, we are able to see difference. And in this case, Autumn Deep is working better because it's more intense. So in this case, the intensity is, increasing, and colors are working better.
So at this point, I can steal some color from the two subgroups that you have shown me, yeah?
So definitely you can wear any colors. So when I compare colors from the Autumn Soft and the Autumn Deep, it's because I'm very picky in choosing your subgroup. But definitely, guys, having a subgroup doesn't mean that you cannot wear this color, or you cannot wear the olive or the mustard yellow. You can wear any color from the Autumn palette. It's just that during an analysis, we want to see which is his predominant characteristic or your predominant characteristic, okay? And this will give you a better idea of what to choose color-wise. But definitely, I'm autumn warm and I'm wearing today an autumn soft jumper. Look at these colors. Amazing on you.
Beautiful colors.
Beautiful colors, definitely. So, Autumn Deep was working better than Autumn Soft, and now we're gonna see Autumn Warm.
Okay, Autumn Warm.
And let's start with this beautiful red. Even this red is working very well on you. Very, very well. Absolutely stunning. It's a very warm red, medium intense. Wow, that's amazing. You have a shirt in this color. You really like it, no? Amazing, this one. It's working very well. This is a Lincoln Green, it's called.
Lincoln Green.
It's working. I think it's way too warm for you. Do you remember during the undertone phase that the undertone at the beginning was not very evident? You were not reacting extremely bad to the wrong color. I think this is a proof that probably your undertone is not gonna be your predominant characteristic, because you are working better with colors that have a medium level of intensity, but they are not extremely warm. In this case, this green is extremely warm. There's a lot of yellow in it. And I think that you are working better with the green that is deeper,
definitely,
a little bit more intense, deeper, and less obviously warm than this one. So everything at the end of an analysis, guy, makes sense, because if we see that the undertone is not clear, probably that is not gonna be the main characteristic of a client, of a person. So now we need to understand which one is his main characteristic. If it's not a warmth, and we saw that even soft colors are not working as well as the more intense one inside the autumn palette, we can start to, you know, have an idea on which one is gonna be his subgroup. That probably is gonna be the deep one.
Oui.
This one is nice because since you are warm, not extremely warm, but still warm, you can definitely wear yellow and orange, the yellow and orange family that are part of your palette. So again, being part of a subgroup doesn't mean that you cannot wear this color, because this color on him is absolutely stunning. This is my palette. And as you can see, we are quite different, right? So it makes sense to think that we are part of two different subgroups, but we can definitely wear all the colors from the autumn palette because we are both autumn. All of them are working. My preference is for the autumn deep. Okay, so now we are gonna see the winter deep palette. That is gonna be your borderline season. You will steal some colors from the winter deep palette because you will share with winter the depth.
Okay.
Let's start with the orchid. In this case, probably that's a very big proof that you are not a winter, but you are an autumn, because this color is a little bit too cool for you. However, in terms of intensity, I think it's matching very, very well. And you are working as well with quite well with black too. Probably a deep brown is more gentle on your skin, is more harmonious and is more gentle on your skin than black, but black is not bad. This is a very big I think a confirmation of your predominant characteristic. An autumn deep person usually react quite well to black, not as good as brown, yes, but it still works in an outfit. I think that violet as a winter deep color is quite cool, but is also quite intense. And in this case, I think that we can definitely confirm your borderline with the high intensity season like winter. A deep eggplant, in your specific case, is working better, definitely, because it's warm. And petroleum is stunning. I don't have to say anything about this. It's 50-50 with teal, definitely. So teal in this case is yellow based, warmer and slightly softer. Petroleum is a little bit more intense and blue based. 50-50 in this case. You're working better. You're working very well with both.
Well, those are two of my favorite colors.
Yeah, no, definitely. They're working very well. Look, even a combination with violet. How stunning is on you. They are a little bit cool, yes, but if you place a petroleum next to your face, wow, it's working very well. Petroleum with the yellow that you are wearing now, amazing. So definitely you can steal colors from the winter deep palette, because the colors share with you your predominant characteristic, that is the depth. You cannot be autumn warm like me, because otherwise you will work quite well with colors from the spring warm palette. And in this case, the intensity is way too much for you and is more visible because the colors are lighter, okay? And since your predominant characteristic is the depth, they appear even brighter than what they actually are, you know? So this one is way too intense for you, and even this one. You can wear it, is warm, but it's gonna be too intense for you, for your characteristic. Winter deep, spring warm. So winter deep is winning, definitely. Too light. You cannot be autumn soft, because otherwise colors from the summer soft palette would work. As you can see, this is definitely not your brown. It's too ashy and rose for you. So very soft and cool. No, this is definitely not working, right? It's too soft and cool, sand. No, you look very gray here. Gray is probably one of your worst color, eh? Gray is a very big enemy of autumn, I think. So the fact that winter deep works better than spring warm and summer soft, it's a proof that you are part of the autumn deep subgroup. So Luce, you are autumn deep.
Yeah.
finally, yeah, we have confirmed your color palette. And now we're gonna see the recap with our frames. So we checked the undertone and we saw that overall warm colors are working much better on you. Then we checked your level of intensity and we saw that probably bright colors are a little bit too much. Are a little bit overpowering on you, and overall you are working better with the colors that are more muted and delicate. So your season is autumn, yeah, and as you can see, all these colors create the perfect frame around your face. Since your main characteristic is the depth, your second best season is winter, since you share with winter the main characteristic, that is the depth. We can see that not all the colors are working on you, but there are some that are working, and you can definitely steal some colors from this palette. Okay, the analysis is done, and you discover that you are autumn deep, and that we both are autumn.
Autumn.
Yeah. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching till this point. Please consider to subscribe to our channel and follow us on Instagram. And if you're interested in a color analysis session here in Melbourne, Australia, or online, feel free to visit our website, coloranalysis.au. I'm gonna see you very soon with more videos. Bye.
Bye-bye.